Well, hello there. Welcome to Pow Pow Island. I'm Lucky, and today we're going to talk about these trees that are standalone little pieces on cliffs. A one cliff tree thing. Thingamabobby. Is it a glitch or is it not? It's been around too long. I think it's actually part of how they programmed the use of the tools. So with that being said, let's get down to the nitty-gritties. Okay, so I have three of them over here, and I also want to just qualify very quickly that whatever size that you plant the tree at, it will stay at that size. So this little guy was planted this size. It hasn't grown. This one's been up on this cliff for about 4 days, and it is still a medium-sized tree. And as a point of interest, just to show what that looks like, we're just going to do a quick overview. Will it show that as an overview here? Yeah, you can see that I've dug a hole there. So this particular little hole is to show that there's nothing behind this. To stunt trees, you just plant one of your native trees, your fruit trees, within one space of whichever tree you want to stunt. And there's one behind here, so this stays large. These are small, and away we go. Okay, that's just to tell you right off the bat that if you're going to do anything with these little guys, the size you plant up on here is the size it stays. Now, to get rid of them, and you can't do anything once they're there. I can't dig around it, can't do anything. Boom, finished. Can't put a ladder up, can't do any of that stuff. It just is, well, I think it's kind of fun to go, well, why not? Why can't I put my ladder up there? Just pressing that A button. Okay, so how do we get rid of them once we've built them is the big question, right? So I'm going to remove this one that I'm standing beside so that I can actually show you how it's done. And the only way to get rid of them is this way. You go into your Island Designer in your phone app there, and you request a cleanup. And this will get rid of the tree. The cliff will still be there. Anything on the ground will, you know, that you've placed will show up in your recycle bin. There you go. So we're going to say, yes, clean things up, please. I want to be done with that. And there it's gone. So now that that's done, once that tree is off there, I now can go ahead and just chop that down. So that's what we're going to do. And what I'm going to do is basically put up 9 pieces, although we only need 8. I'm just going to go ahead and put this just to show you. It's a 3x3 grid basically is what you need. So we're going to cruise along here. Get that one up. And this one. And I'll actually put 3 out back. Now I can leave this corner here because technically you need one corner free, okay? Out front preferably because, you know, it's hard to see what you're doing out back. Although you can easily carve out back as well. So one of the two front corners needs to be missing, and you're going to stand inside that space and you're going to get your water tool. And now you can see when you get that water tool, it turns you around. My back has to face the wall, and I carve myself a water hole. I turn myself with my back, oopsie-daisy, against the wall, and I have these. So basically, you're whichever way you'd like to do this, I say the back against the wall. So when my back is against this side, I dig this hole. Back is against this side, I dig this hole. Once those two holes are done, jump over them, turn yourself around, and face into the square. So now I'm actually facing into the square. If you're not quite perfectly lined up, you'll fill in a hole. Just, you know, make it happen. And then you go ahead and carve an angle. Now, this is what's interesting about this. This has to be done this way. I've experimented it with all kinds of other patterns and designs. It's actually this one here that's the key. By angling this, it recognizes that this space is utilized. Now, I'm not quite sure what happens here, but I think by the way this is set up here, it's recognizing this as being filled in, okay? Because once you climb up there, up on top, and, oh, did I bring a tree with me? Hold on a second, I don't think I did. Nope, let me just go grab a little tree. I've been planting these for this specific reason. These teeny tiny trees, I love them when they're little like this, okay. Okay, so let's run on over here and we're gonna climb back up here. Now, if that water piece wasn't down there and I tried this, Without the water down below, it will let you dig the hole, but it won't let you put the tree in it. So it would let, you know, you can go ahead and do that, but it wouldn't let me put the tree in if I did not have the water down below. So it must be that pattern. Also, the 3x3 is the minimum size for planting a tree anyways, if you want to carve the edges to make it look round. In other words, every tree needs to have one full space around it. Okay, so that's why this is interesting, and I always viewed it as a bit of an anomaly. But they've left it, so as far as I'm concerned, it's open game. We're going to plant the small young cedar, and see, it lets you do it. Now, here's where it gets not tricky, but where you have to actually pay attention. Before I climb down, I'm going to see if we can see it from here. But you can now see that there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I want to end up with these four staying there for a moment. I want to get rid of these two and those two. So whatever side you've got your missing piece, that's your clue to get rid of those two and those two. You want to be left with the four piece standing. Now, in order to do that, let's actually get rid of the water. We don't need that water down there. Because now that the tree's up there, it's kind of bizarre, isn't it, that you can get rid of this. Oops-a-daisy. Now, let's take a little look at what this means. Let's get our cliff tool. And I'm going to go ahead and take this piece off. And of course, because it's touching two other sides of land, it only takes half of it away. But now I'm going to go to the full corner and take that away. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to go to this side here. And I'm going to carve away half of that corner, because that's all it will take. If I stayed there, just so we're on the same page, if I stayed there and continued carving, isn't that interesting? So I've not ever done that. So it's telling you it's dangerous to modify this clip because there's a tree above that might fall. But watch what happens if I take the corner. This is what you're wanting to do, is take the corner. Now, you see how I've got those four little pieces? Here's the glitch now. You cannot cut this one away first. Think in terms of the tree and the two squares touching it. Those are the ones that have to be cut. And what that looks like, before I do it here in the tree, I've made this mock-up here. Okay, I've got four little squares. I'm going to hit this one. And then I'm going to go around and hit the other one that's touching the tree. So that little pitfall seed is a tree. And now we're left with this. So you can see that I took half and half of the corners. And now I've got a square and a square and two halves. If I hit this, it's going to take all of that away. Okay, so watch that. Now, just as an observation, okay, so we're on the same page. If you turn around and cut this back one, now what happens is you're stuck. If you hit this side, it'll take a piece and a half, and then you've got a standalone piece. Once you have done that, you cannot correct it. You'd have to start again. So this, at this point, I can cut it here because it's not a real tree. But if I did that over here now, if I went over here and carved this corner, I would not have this little tree like this. It'd always be one piece attached. So really be mindful of cutting the corner off of the two cubes that touch the tree. Then you're left with this little standalone piece here now, where you cut this off and the whole thing goes. All right, that's how it's done, everybody. Once you've got it there, though, it stays. You can't change the tree. The tree doesn't grow any bigger or doesn't do anything different. That's it. And any tree can be put up on a cliff like that, a full-grown fruit tree. I just love these little guys. They're so cute. So at this point, we're done with the tutorial, but I will just show you something and do a little further explanation if you're just interested in seeing when you want to build this where you've already got lots of activity. So for example, in here, originally I had two little cliff pieces here. My fence was open and I could jump over this way. But I thought, wouldn't it be cool to have a little tree here? So I stunted this tree, very similar. You can do the bamboo trees the same way. Your native fruit is used. I'll link to the video that I talk about stunting trees so that you have that in case you're not familiar with it. So let me just take a few things away here and then just show you what I did. So all I can suggest is that when you want to add something close to other cliffs, but you want it to be by itself, you are going to have to remove everything to have it as a standalone piece. So, cliff's edges, as you know, you have to have one lip when you're on the second level. So the space behind this one and this one and this one made it 3x3. So I carved away, I took a picture of it first, carved away everything, filled in the water, carved away this, so that I could put the three pieces up, get that corner out, put my water carving in here, climb up, plant this little bamboo, which is the large bamboo, not quite full grown. And then once I came down and cut everything away, I went and filled it all in and put it back into shape. I used to have water running on either side of my two little cliff pieces before the tree, but you cannot have water next to a cliff where there's a tree like that. It won't let you do that. So in this instance, it worked out nicely for me here. I really enjoy the look of it. And this is a large bamboo tree that is the next stage would be full grown. So it won't grow any further than that. And what that actually, just visually, I don't know if you're aware that you can do it. So here are the full grown ones. I'm standing next to them. You can see that they have way more foliage down here than that one does. And I have another medium-sized one right here. Or did I have a little, is that still the little one? That might just be the medium one. So whatever this little guy here is, that's what's on that tree over here, if I'm not mistaken. There's, you know, the five stages technically. So this may actually even be the larger than that one. Yes. So there you go. You have now learned how to do this tree. I don't feel bad teaching it to you. I'm not a fan of showing a lot of stuff that really isn't supposed to be done, just simply because then it messes with you know, the game and whatnot. But they've had this now for so long that I think, you know what, hey, we're just gonna go for it. We're gonna share it and show you how it's done. But don't those look adorable? So let me know what you think. I'm gonna throw out some joy and happiness for everybody. Grab some, enjoy it, share it, because you know, if you share it, it definitely comes back to you. Thanks for hanging out with me. I hope you liked this video. If you did, well, you know, let me know in the comments below if you got these already on your island or if you're planning on doing it. If you have any questions, you know, I always answer my questions for sure. Hey, thanks for subscribing. Appreciate that. And if you like it, great. That makes me smile. In the meantime, take care, be safe, be happy, and keep on smiling. Bye-bye.